British Gas. Tom, welcome.
Can everyone hear me? Okay, well, thanks for the introduction. I appreciate that. I also appreciate this is a Sunday morning, and generally people like better things from you on a Sunday morning. So, you know, the fact you're here means you have questions and there are concerns. And, you know, I hope we can, help address some of those. Again, by way of introduction, Ormil Energy, we're a publicly listed company who we're a very small company, you can see by this on the scale of, and I've just included companies that are involved in coal seam method in New South Wales or trying to do that business in New South Wales. You know, we barely rank as the line thickness on the end, but what happened is the way that Ormil got involved in this project, this was a project that was originally identified by Apex. There had been one well drilled in 2004, and it showed some gas potential. There was an application in 2007, so this has been, you know, a publicly available project. You know, the data's been available since 2007. And the reason that Ormil got involved in it is we saw this. Am I clicking or buttoning? There we go. Okay, so. From our point of view, we saw this as a great opportunity and a great project because we saw two things. One is a great demand for energy in New South Wales, where New South Wales uses more energy than any other state. Plus, there's very little indigenous energy except for coal, which was the other part of why we thought this was a great project and why we got involved in it. It's well established by numerous studies around the world, and you know if you want to, I mean, not many people have a coal-fired oven. Gas burns cleaner than coal. So we have, there was a report commissioned by GE, not that long ago, this is about a year old, by a company called Vivid Economics, and their one blanket conclusion from one organization summed it up as Australia is the worst polluter of carbon dioxide in the world. Per capita basis. This other chart is from last weekend's Australian newspaper, and it shows clearly, and this is publicly, this is well-known data, that gas burns better than coal, and I was specifically using coal seam methane gas for domestic gas plants. It is one of the cleanest, ways of, yep. Is it because I'm too close or too far? Oh. Is that better? Sorry. Okay. So, so the gas is a far cleaner burning fuel than coal. So for us, as a small company, we said, well, this looks like a no-brainer in a sense. And the beauty of being a small company is a couple of advantages we see. Is one is our independent experts are truly independent. They're not people that we have on staff. We hire people that are, that know their field, they're independent, their reputations depend on their opinions, and the ones we've used for this project are all within the community. So these people are, responsible, their opinions reflect what, they live in the community, so they're not just telling us what we want to hear. They're truly independent. And the other advantage and disadvantage sometimes of being a small company is that if there's problems or if there's issues, you don't call our PR department or our legal department. You can call me or send an email directly to the people that run the company. And in our case, the buck stops with me.
Tom, we might just have a little disagreement.
Yep. So for us, we thought, this is a great project. What could go wrong here? So we were surprised when we woke up one morning and this headline was in the paper. Cover up, secret plan to mine gas. And we thought, well, because there's actually three errors in the headline, and even in the first sentence there's two more errors, we were quite, well, first of all, this has been project that's been publicly available since 2007. So there's no secret plan, there's no cover-up, you don't mine gas. But to be honest, we were quite thrilled to find that even though we had yet to drill one well, we already had billions of dollars worth of gas. And honestly, our share price actually spiked that day. So, you know, as an executive, I mean, I promptly made the decision to ignore this, because how can I take this seriously when there's four errors just in the first 10 words? And of course, I realize it's, you know, quite rare for the press to make mistakes, especially since apparently they seem to be listening to our conversations. But, you know, in this rare case, I think they may have made, we thought they'd made some errors. So we were still encouraged with the project. This is a slide that was presented to ministers in New South Wales recently, on average, one CSG well produces the equivalent energy of 85,000 tons of coal and has between 50 and 70% less greenhouse emissions. So again, this seems like a great project. Now, I'm here to talk about CSG Illawarra. I'm not going to talk about CSG, obviously in some sense CSG in general, but specifically our project in the Illawarra and what we're doing there. So this shows where our areas are, and where some of the well locations or proposed well locations are. Again, we have yet to drill a well. We're not even sure if there's anything there yet. The one well we drilled in 2004 there was some gas, but it's quite inconclusive. So the second slide also shows, I think, an important point, which is that most of this area has already been heavily mined for coal. So all of the 15 wells are in and around areas that have already been, you know, heavily mined. And the Illawarra coal mining has been going on for over 100 years. This is a close-up of the area, of some of the areas. And one thing that struck me is, I've been reading these, and I've been looking at the website, I'm kind of confused sometimes about the information that we seem to be feeding out never seems to be coming back. Now, but for me, a common sense view of this is we have a coal seam, and the coal seam contains coal, gas, and water. Now, for 100 years, we've been taking this coal seam, stripping out the coal, the gas, and the water, and, you know, in all these areas around the Illawarra, I mean, all this has been heavily mined for 100 years. So what happens to that gas? Well, that gas goes into the atmosphere. It hasn't been captured for the most part. What happens to the water? Well, the water, over 100 years, has been, there are established methods of disposing of the water that's in that gas. So what are we proposing to do? We're proposing to go to seams, these same seams that are too deep to mine and too expensive to mine, and we're going down there, we're drilling a hole, and we're capturing the gas, we're not releasing it to the atmosphere, and we're producing the same water that's come from all these millions of tons of coal that have already been mined, and we're disposing of it in similar ways, you know, in the same ways, well-established ways. So, again, we're honestly confused about, okay, if we're actually taking less things out of the ground, how can it all of a sudden be worse? So when we started doing our research in the area, and this was a data collection process, we found that in this area, there's been over 10,000 boreholes already drilled. In the South Sydney Basin, there's been about 3,000 boreholes already drilled for water, for coal exploration, and some for CBM, and also for conventional oil and gas. This data is, the feedback we've recently gotten from the DPI, and we already know this. There's no difference between the three wells that we're proposing and most of the 3,000 wells that have already been drilled in the area. The main differences are we are going after a different resource. We're just capturing the coal, and you know, we're just trying to capture the gas. We're not, you know, ripping up the coal. We're just trying to capture the gas. The second point is that we're under, because of all the, you know, because it's a newer industry than coal mining, which is well established, and you know, they've had thousands of community meetings and people understand it a lot better. There seems to be not that much, you know, people aren't protesting and wearing stop coal mining because it's already been going on for, you know, 100 years. So, well, So what we're saying is the holes that we're planning to drill are no different than many of the holes that have already been drilled, except we're under a lot closer scrutiny as well. Minutes? Okay, so I'll just quickly talk about probably a couple of the main issues. One are the water management. That's an issue because we're drilling the wells the same way that have already been drilled for these 3,000 wells. The water management issues are well handled. The second is there are no aquifers in the area. So even still within, you know, the website and here we talk about water aquifer contamination. There are no aquifers. So there, we can't contaminate something that isn't there.
So
we're not, anyway. It is important, and I thought maybe that would come up in the question. But in the water catchment area, there's already been 150 wells drilled by the catchment authority in the same area. This is exactly the same as the wells that we're planning on drilling. There's wells that have been drilled already with the same specifications, the same, you know, except they were looking for different things. They were trying to find about the geologic strata, but it's the same well designs. So the wells have already been drilled there, the procedures are already in place, and the catchment isn't worried about their own wells or other people's wells. It's because this is a new industry, but it's a new industry, but not a new technology for drilling. New South Wales coals are some of the driest in the country, so even if we get to a production stage, we have a lot less of this water to manage or to handle. And the other thing, we keep saying we will not be fracking any of these wells, and yet this keeps showing up. In none of the Illawarra areas will we ever frack a well there. So I have no idea why we're debating something in this area that is something that will not happen. So again, I'll just to sum up, I'll come back to, look, when we originally got involved in this, we said, this seems like a good project. You know, lower greenhouse gas emissions, displacing coal. So we started doing some research, and what we found, we found some minutes for a pre-election meeting that went on in October, and these were groups like the NCC, Greenpeace, NCC, I've already said that. And this was sort of an election strategy meeting, pre-election. This is in October 2010. And you can see two of the quotes there. They're clearly at that point, no one is really anti-CSG. They acknowledge that, look, we need to be cautious about calling for a ban on CSG because it's less intensive, greenhouse intensive than coal. But let's not undermine local campaigners because, you know, they might get some kind of traction. They might get some kind of, you know, feedback, some fear is the way we see it, some fear in the community. So this is our belief of why this thing seemed to have escalated, because we fed tons of information back to some of these groups. And so just to finalize, the Stop CSG Illawarra group say they're non-political, yet I've just become aware that two of the founders of the group are standing for community elections, you know, 15 days and 15 minutes away. I find it must be just some mad coincidence that this meeting is being held here at this time by people who've started this organization that are now looking for public office. So now my point is, look, gas is cleaner than coal. We are not fracking, so let's not debate fracking, or there is no aquifer, so let's not talk about these aquifers that don't exist. And let's more facts and less fear. You know what? You may be shocked as I was to find this, but people with political agendas in newspapers are probably not the best source of information. And people who have a vested economic interest are probably not the best source of information. Do your own homework. But don't just, you know, don't just read things that are shoved down your throat. I can go by item on this petition. But my view is now well known, and you know, I'm happy to address any questions, and I'm sure there'll be some. So thank you.